Christ. I'm looking at some of you and you look like you need. You mean to tell me the one who sits on the circle of the universe
come on.
Will give me the strength that I need to get through this
thing? Yeah.
Watch this. David did not need Red Bull. He didn't even need monster drinks to get through verse 2 and verse 3. He didn't even need Rockstar or 5-hour energy drinks to boost him. All he had was God's strength. And why don't you tell your neighbor, that's all you really need is the Lord's strength. And one of the inalienable privileges of being a child of God is that he always provides what we need when we need it without my asking him or without my help. You'll notice in this verse 1 that David didn't ask for any of this. Because we have the tendency that when we're going through, our emotions and our feelings get in the way of what we should be asking God for to get us through. Lord, bless me with a new man in my life. That ain't what you need. Come on, help me here. Tap somebody and say, Daddy knows best. It was a man that got you in the trouble. He gives us strength, he gives us light, and he gives us salvation. I ask you tonight, can Dish Network, CenturyLink, Cox Cable give you all of that? Tap your neighbor and say, before I walk out of here, I'm a bundle with God. The next time, you know, just remind the devil, hold the devil, I bundle with God. Next time your enemies come upon you, tell them, I bundle with God. Do I have a witness here? But then, secondly, let me just give you this last one. I'll hump this off. Not only does God provide, and I hope this is helping you contribute to a winning attitude. Watch this. Not only does he provide, but then God preserves. Watch verse 3 of the text. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, he says, in this will I be confident. David says, watch this, and the operative word in this text is heart. He says, my heart shall not fear. Meaning, he says, my heart in the midst of what I'm going through is kept. Do I have a witness here? He said, my heart is maintained. He says, despite what I go through, he keeps my heart in the original state it was in. When I went into the mess, I came out with my heart. Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
Some of you went into the situation with your heart, and you've come out with no heart. Do I have a witness here? But I'm here to tell you tonight that the Lord will preserve you. Tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, the Lord will preserve you. David says, he keeps me in a state of mind, or he keeps me in my right mind. And by the time he gets to verse 3 of this text, he comes to the conclusion that it's the Lord who keeps me in the same condition as before. And that's why he says, my heart shall not fear. Do I have a witness here? Though an host should encamp against me. David said, the same way I went in is the same way I came out. Do I have a witness here? Tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, God will preserve you. Do I have a witness here? Cancer should have taken you out a long time ago. But look at you now. Crap almost destroyed you. But look at you now. Abused and battered all your life. But tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, look at me now. Molested as a child and teen by someone you trusted. But look at you now. Abandoned by your parents at an early age. But look at you now. Incarcerated and treated like an animal. But look at you now. Tap your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't look the same as when I went in before. That's God preserving you. Do I have a witness? Identity issues all your life. And feelings of inferiority and low self-esteem. But God kept you. And God preserved you. And you can stand up and tell your neighbor, neighbor, look at me now. At adolescence, exposed to the occult and the occult. But look at me now. Voted most person least likely to succeed. But look at me now. I stopped by here tonight to tell you, look at me now. It may not look like that I've been through anything, but you don't know my story. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, I wish I had a witness here. The Lord preserved me. Do I have a witness here? In my life, and I'm gonna borrow it from how the old folk used to sing it. This is a new theme song in my life. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? Y'all acting like you don't know that song. For he kept my enemies away. He left us up. Y'all just don't miss this. Do I have a witness? Look preserve me. And so I'm going to drop it like it's hot. If you got it, funny. Because you only look the way you do. Because he preserved you. He preserved you, my love. Your attitude ought to be the best amongst many churches. He preserved you 76 years. You ought to have the best attitude. You ought to be the example. And wherever you go, I wish I had the time. When David gets to that verse 10 and he says, the Lord will take me up. I'm done. I've been preaching every day for a whole week and I'm tired. But if I had time, when he said the Lord would take me up, what he had in mind as Israel, and he reflected, Mother, when Israel was going through the wilderness, there were laggards and stragglers that just got tired of the journey. Tell your neighbor, you can't get tired of the journey yet. You're at your best. Come on, I'm tired.
Lord Jesus, thank you.
Well, what would happen? God would provide what was called rear guards. And as those stragglers and laggards, old folk and children would lag behind, God didn't write them off. I hear folks talk about it all the time. Well, you know, if you get behind God, you know, you out of his will. Well, every now and then you get tired. But God provides rear guards. And what those rear guards did, Doc, is that they would pick up the stragglers, take them to the front of the tribe. And if they needed to be propped up, those rear guards. And what David is saying is, in my worst case scenario, God will be my rear guard. Just go like this, stay up.
Stay up.
Don't let nobody break you down. down. Did God put you up there? Stand up. Don't let folk get mad at you because you up. Mama, now y'all up there. I don't think you realize that everything that God did for David, he did for this church. You guys are a pillar in this community. I heard the guy, the fellow, talk about how many years he can go back. You are a pillar in this community, Lord. You set the trail for everybody. That's why I would wonder when you hear about somebody from Mount Olive acting up, it's like, ooh, they like the mother church. You gotta stay up. I just want to pray for a couple folk real quick. I know about it, but you say, Pastor, I feel like one of those laggers. I feel like one of those stragglers in the ministry. I've been lagging behind. God's trying to do things in this place. And I've just been a straggler. And you need a rear guard. Here's what I'm saying. If you still mad, you're straggling. If you still got an attitude after all these years, you need a rear guard. You need a rear guard. Because new things are happening here. You have a pastor who has a magnitude vision.
Yes, yes.
And if you fight, you need a rear guard. Fussing, complaining, you need a rear guard. I just want to pray. You say, Pastor, and maybe that's not your situation, but I'm open to pray. If you say, Pastor, I need a rear guard. I need to get up and I need to stay up. I want you to come. Don't care about what anybody looking or thinking. I need a rear guard. And I guarantee you, if you open yourself to the Lord, He'll promote you and bring you in front of the line. You say, Pastor, I need the help to get to the front. I want you to come. Won't you stand to your feet? I want you to come. We all straggle, we all laugh. Father, right now, those who have come, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that you help us get us to the front of the line right now, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, that you pour into my two sisters here strength, pour into them your light. Pour into them salvation, a way out of the worst case scenario in their life. And if we're lagging and straggling behind right now in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, put these two ladies right now in the front. Go in love and go in peace. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big hand. Let's go right to the praise.